So the 10th edition of the Goa Arts and Literature Festival is coming to an end. This is the last session. And this is a good time as any other to discuss whether literature festivals have any literature in them. Or is it just, you know, a parade of the rich and the famous authors. And what does it do? What do literature festivals actually do to promote literature? And what kind of literature is then actually promoted? So there are many questions here, and then we'll just go briefly through the panel and then open it up for questions. So I hope you will be engaging participants in the discussion. For this panel discussion, we have Astri Ghosh, who has translated a lot of Tagore. She's translated a lot of Ibsen between Norwegian and English and Hindi. We have Mitra Phukan, who primarily writes in English. She's based in Guwahati. And we have Mr. Damodar Mauzo, who writes in Konkani primarily. But he's here because he's the co-curator of this literature festival. We initially had a fourth person, Sumana Roy, who could not make it, so she's not part of this discussion. And Dilip D'Souza, who for other reasons could not be a part of this discussion. So when we are talking about appreciation of literature, or the absence or the presence of literature in a literature festival, what are we talking about? What do we mean by literature? And we'll confine ourselves to a few points. Is there more reading? We have a bookshop outside, so there are books definitely selling, but it's usually the person who's coming for a book usually knows what he or she is coming for. So there's no attempt to try a different genre or to try a different author or to try a different book. So how much of reading is actually encouraged by a literature festival? How much of writing is encouraged? That we'll never know, because if somebody's writing purely on a blog or is just writing for his own personal consumption, we'll never know that. And then finally, how much of appreciation of literature? How do we measure that? Do we measure by how full the halls are during sessions? So there are questions about literature itself and what we are trying to achieve through literature festivals. So I'll start with Mr. Mauzo first, and I want to ask you, sir, when you started GALF 10 years ago, 2010, I think, what was the primary motivating factor? And what did you want to achieve? And then as a corollary to that, how much of it have you achieved?
Thank you, Leonard. Well, when we started GALF 10 years back, the primary motive was to hold one literature festival. So I was having this idea because that year we were celebrating Bakiba Borkar, our leading poet, his anniversary, 100th anniversary, birth centenary rather. And by the time we discussed about our festival, I was discussing with Vivek, because we are both members of Goa Writers Group. And Vivek, I had written one article about Bakiba Borkar, in which I had said Bakiba Borkar was very closely connected with Angelo de Fonseca. And Angelo de Fonseca, gathering inspiration from Angelo, he himself has painted a sketch of his own wife. And I had seen it with my own eyes when I visited him. And I said, then Vivek immediately jumped up on the idea. He said, wow, we shall celebrate both arts and literature. That is how it became Art and Literature Festival. Meanwhile, the then director of ICG, Nandini Sahai, she also was, pondering over the idea of holding literature festivals. That was just the time when generals, Jaipur Festival and other festivals are just coming up. So she said, she came to me, because Maria Aurora Kuto, she referred to her that you can meet Damodar and Vivek and all. And we were at the Goa Writers Meet where she came and discussed with us, and that is how Goa art and literature came into being. But before that, since we were organizing this Baki Bab Borkar centenary event, it was art and culture department decided to hold it. And at the behest of the director, I called Dr. Anantamurthy, who accepted the invitation to be for this centenary. And then we were thinking of, we didn't have much of budget, but we were thinking of inviting some luminary to inaugurate. Then I said, why not Dr. Anantamurthy? He's coming to Margao for that festival. So I called him. After a bit of hesitation, he accepted. And then there was no end to it. I think until the first festival was over, we never had thought that this will be a perpetual thing, or it will last for 10 years at least. That is how it started. But yeah. The motive was definitely not to promote literature initially. But when we saw the literary enthusiasts coming and attending the festival, and we ourselves thought, no, this is the platform where we can promote literature in Goa and outside Goa also.
Thank you. I'll just go to Mitra Phukan. So Mr. Mauzo spoke about Jaipur. And Jaipur, you know, is all about the big names. It's about who is coming, from where they are coming, what kind of books they have. Mr. Hazarika was talking about the Brahmaputra festival. You're having it in February. And some 110 people, and he was talking about writers from England and Sweden. So it seems that literature festivals are about the big names. I want to get a sense from you about where does the breakout author fit in? The person, so if when you're talking about literature, you're doing work that is already, does not need to be done, right? You don't need to introduce Margaret Atwood, or you don't need to introduce, And yet literature festivals about them, you will say, okay, Margaret Atwood is attending, this Indian writer is attending. So where does the breakout author fit, or where does the, you know, the person, so is it about the glamour quotient, or is there a literary quotient to the literature festival?
Thank you for that kind of difficult question. Definitely big names are there, definitely, and they attract the most people. But people like us who come from peripheries, but where literature is still very strong in Assamese, for instance, or in all the states of our region, whether it's oral literature or whether it is written literature in the various tongues that we have, it's very strong, okay? And I never really think where is the literature, because it is literature. And the fact that I am talking about the literature from my region, I think it's actually a great privilege and an honor, because we come from a region which for instance, yesterday there was the land beyond the Ganga and all that, the relevance and all that. So the perception is still there. So if I can talk of Indira Goswami from my land, of Biren Bhattacharji from my, or so many other, from the various other that I know about, yes, I feel privileged that they are. And then I find that it is not just the big ones, because we all attend the smaller ones also. In fact, I love going to the smaller places, because, for instance, recently I was in Arunachal, in a tiny little place, and before that I was in Ukyo Lit Fest in Manipur, okay? And the amount of enthusiasm, the school children were coming, the amount of enthusiasm for books, they were lined up for our signatures. And they actually read it, and there were people who came and they said, we have read your book, and now this is a dog-eared copy, please sign it. So that was really, really nice. And it's not just, you know, about me or somebody, definitely, and we must remember that it is not just the, there are so many hundreds of book fair, literature festivals
yeah.
these days. There are a few big ones. In our consciousness, we think of Jaipur, we think of so many, the other ones, the Times Lit Fests and all that. Goa is positioned in between, growing, but positioned in between. But there are all the smaller ones, which actually are very heartwarming. And it is about literature there. Definitely, it is about literature. The small place that I had gone to is the Zero Lit Fest in a remote part of Arunachal, where the Apatani tribe is there. And it was joined with the Zero Music Festival. So there were people from all over the world to come to that music festival, and they came to the Lit Fest also. And because theirs is an oral literature, just emerging, coming from orality to the written word. So that kind of thing. And then you find that these are readers who are reading possibly for the first time in their generations, you know, because they are moving from, and they are, these are languages without scripts so far. So then you feel as if you're part of some kind of a historical process, because you are there and they have come, they are listening to you, they will possibly read your book, they have certainly read some of your friends' books. So literature is very much present in these literature.
Yes, so I have difficulty with that point you're making, because these are readers already reading, right? Do you see literature festivals actually encouraging reading among non-readers? Because these people are already on your side. But from a literature festival point of view, just to stay on topic here, are you making readers out of non-readers? Are you making writers out of non-writers?
So, I don't know about writers. Writers will not be created out of a literature festival. I don't think so. Do you think so? So I don't think writers are created.
Yeah.
But readers, we have this huge festival known as Sahitya Sabha, Assam, to which you had gone at one session.
Who let people say?
Exactly, right? It was Sahitya Sabha, and it's a yearly, annual event. And people from, it's held in different small towns, sometimes in Guwahati, but usually in small towns all over. And the publishers come, and the publishers and sellers come. And I am amazed at the rivers of people who come, who pick up books. These are people from the villages, okay? They are not really readers as such, you know? Not the kind who will have a library in the home and who has books from so many decades and so on. But they will come, and it is hard-earned money. Of course, our regional books are cheaper, but even so, it's hard-earned money, and they are spending on this, and they will, of course, read it. Why would they buy it otherwise? It doesn't have snob. They don't know the meaning of snob value of books. They have come, they will, and I find that many of them are sharing, pooling their resources. They will buy, you were the chief guest, so they will buy your book and they will read it. They will pool their resources, they will share among themselves, and they will read it. So yes, it does. We must remember that Lit Fests are not just Jaipur and Delhi and Mumbai and so on. It is also the smaller places where readers, I feel, are being created.
Astri, I'll ask you, like, you have translated works, you have written your own stuff. As an author going to a Lit Fest, what are you expecting out of that? And to what degree are your expectations being met?
What I've published recently has been translations from Norwegian to Hindi. Now, when I come with a Hindi book to a Lit Fest like Goa, I don't really expect a lot of people to be interested in it. So yesterday in the morning, we had a session, the launch of my Ibsen plays, and there were two adults in the audience, and the rest were a class of Sharda Mandir and another school. And halfway through, the other school's teachers said, the children should get up, so one whole class got up and walked out. But what I thought was that, okay, this is my opportunity to talk to children about Ibsen, to talk about translation, and whatever you know, you've got to then moderate what you're saying, you've got to think about what you're saying. Now you're talking to a classroom, basically. It's an opportunity to meet a new audience and to discuss Ibsen with them. And they had questions and they had thoughts. And so I just thought, all right, I'm getting an opportunity to speak to an audience that doesn't know Ibsen, and I'm talking to them about Ibsen and translation and translation between cultures and all of that. And that was interesting. Once at Jaipur, I remember talking to some school kids, because this whole thing about literary festivals and school buses coming there, it's an attempt by schools to introduce their students to literature. And so I asked, what have you come for? Whom are you listening to in Jaipur? And the guy said, Suna Salman Khan are. So I said, no, it's not Salman Khan. It's actually Salman Khurshid. You know, he's got a session over there. No. We know it. Salman Khan is coming. So I just thought, well, you know, if Salman Khan brings you here, you might not listen to Salman Khurshid, but you will get, you know, an opportunity to meet authors. And that's one of the aspects. I've been to different sorts of festivals. I went to a wonderful translators festival in Ahmedabad, organized by Rita Kothari, which was a new experience for me. But I went to a festival in Noida, which was organized at the Asian Film and TV Institute. And the audience there, I mean, it was film students mainly, and it was for the release of my first four Ibsen translations of plays. And it was packed so that they were sitting, you know, from here to that wall. And they were asking questions. And so I'm just saying, okay, it might not be the kind of the objective that you have of going to a festival. But for me, going to a festival means meeting like-minded people, getting books. I just moved house and I have still got many, many cartons of books that I have to unload. Many of them I bought here at festivals. You meet authors, you relate with them in a different way. It gives you inspiration to write. It gives you that, you know, you're sitting in your room and writing and translating usually by yourself. It's a very solitary experience. So this, a literary festival is an occasion where you go out and you meet others, you get that charge of, it's your B12 injection, you know, and you come out of there and you charge it a bit and you get some energy to go on.
Yes.
I agree with Astri. When I go for festival, I don't go with some expectations, but whatever I get, I'm happy with it. I met several of my writer friends, and that is the plus point. I met Astri herself at Hyderabad. I met Mitra at Brahmaputra Festival. I met Harish Trivedi at Festival of Letters. I met Antara in Jaipur Festival. I met Hemant Devte, who is sitting here at Gateway Festival. And many festivals. Mridula Garg is sitting here. We were together at Itanagar for this Arunachal Pradesh festival. So this is one way of meeting and exchanging. Just meeting is not enough. We exchange ideas, we discuss, and that adds to my life experience, I feel. And of course, meeting the writers, readers. I was in Uti last September, and I tell you, it is a small festival where hardly 25 to 30 writers are invited, and about 100 to 150 are in the audience. But the enthusiasm among the locals is tremendous. People come from as far as Kannur to attend the festival, in Uti festival. And I tell you, unique experience that I had, I think that day, my books, at least 100 books were sold just after my presentation. So that is the pleasure that I get. So many writers I meet, so many readers I get, new readers I get. So this is the plus point that I get.
I just want to ask you the next question. So when you take stock of, so you're sitting next week and taking stock of this one, how do you evaluate each? How do you say, okay, this went well, this did not go well? What is it you're looking for?
No, as I said, since I go without any expectations, whatever I get, I'm happy with it.
No, what I meant is,
but
yeah.
As far as Goa Literature Festival, I can tell you, the first one, first edition, became so successful, not in terms of the size of the audience, but in terms of the quality of audience and in the quality of the sessions. So we got inspired by that response. And then gradually, we found more and more people wanting to come to the festival. Now, right now, I can say at least 10 of, or 20 of my writer friends who were keen on coming to the festival, I had to say, sorry, we can't. We are keen on keeping the size also limited because it should be manageable. I found Uti Festival doing justice to the festival by inviting only 25 to 30 writers because they can personally attend to them, and it's only one hall where everything is conducted, not parallel sessions. In parallel sessions, we miss out something, but we also can accommodate so many things. Anything else you wanted to know?
No, I just wanted to know what, meaning how do you decide, okay, this one went well, this, in the sense that
I think you should rely upon your senses. I personally, I can tell you, this year's GALF edition is better than last year's. That's the way I look at it. I have attended nearly about 20 festivals, maybe more, but then I feel I am not disappointed by any festival. If at all I am disappointed, I would say Jaipur Festival, when I was sharing the platform with Esther David, and the hall was jam-packed. The volunteers had to struggle to take me to the podium or to the dais. But then, even though I could establish eye contact, I found the audience not as responsive as I expected to be. So somehow, that satisfaction I could not draw, as if I was addressing to some aliens, some people who are not in the in literature. But then here you don't find it, maybe because of the intimate ambience that you experience here. And so also I found pleasure when I was attending Uti Literature Festival. Hyderabad Festival, I don't know. I can't say because I had probably better expectations from that after going there. I felt, okay, this is just okay. But then, as I said, Sahitya Academy conducts literary festivals every year, Festival of Letters, they call it. Again, there, my experience is not as good as other festivals. I don't know, don't ask me why. But somehow, my senses tell me, no, the smaller the festival, it's better the festival.
I'll open it for questions. Please feel free to ask a question. But before that, I just want to ask all three of you. Somehow, English is the predominant language in most festivals. Is that okay? Does it have to have more of Indian languages? What is your take on it? Because I know Mr. Mauzo and I, we have discussed this before also about Konkani. But yeah, you can.
Okay, so I write my own novels and short stories in English, but I also translate from Assamese into English. And in all the festivals I have gone, I have found the literature of that region also on display. For instance, Konkani, I have learned over the years in this festival so much about this, so which I would not have learned if I had not come to Goa Lit Fest, because it would not have been projected in that way in, say, Jaipur or Delhi or someplace. Similarly, in all the places, okay, English may be the predominant one, but there is also these other literatures to which I personally have been exposed, which I would not have been exposed to otherwise. So,
To the degree that you think should happen, in the sense that if there are two languages, if it's Konkani and English,
yeah.
So do you think it should be a 50-50? I'm just asking for your take on it.
I can speak about my own state,
yeah,
my own thing.
Assamese.
Assam and Assamese, because we have a huge number of Sahitya Sabhas. We have a huge, every region, every you know, Kamrup Sahitya Sabha, Tinsukia Sahitya Sabha. So there's a huge Sahitya Sabha ambience. And also, you know, Lekhika Homaro, which is like women's writers, which is also very, very vibrant, and all kinds of Sahitya, to which writers in English are not invited.
Okay.
Yes. So I think this kind of evens out the thing.
I just had to eat my experience at Brahmaputra Literature Festival. I was very, you know, happy to be there. A lot of people sitting in the audience, along with students also. And as I started, I simply asked them, "Can I, if I speak in English, how many people can understand?" Not a single hand came up. So that is the reason, probably. It is difficult to communicate with the audience. Then I switch over to Hindi, which is not my language, but I managed to.
Yeah.
And they also enjoyed it.
Yeah.
But this is one problem when you go interiors, not in the state like Goa, where people can easily follow English. But will Astri speak now?
No, please.
Okay. Since I am a regional language writer, I probably have a prerogative to speak over this. I personally feel that regional language literatures must be discussed at festivals like this. As Mitra just told, it is because of festival in Goa that Kokani literature is known to the people outside Goa. So this is one plus point. We can take our festivals, our literature outside Goa to other readers or other writers. And I think there was a time 10 years back, almost 90% of the writers' community did not know that there is a literature happening in Goa in Konkani. Today it is not the case. Today even Konkani literature is getting being discussed at literary festivals. This is one thing. In festival like ours, we find very few Konkani writers coming, very few Marathi writers, whoever they are. They're not that they are least bothered, but they feel they have no role to play. In my personal opinion, being in the audience, that is also a role to play, because you learn so much. Unfortunately, they cannot communicate in English. So that is a major problem with the regional language writers. So my personal opinion, I always tell them, develop the communicative skills to discuss our literature through English medium. I'm sure this festival or such festivals should not be only for Indo-Anglian writers. It should be necessarily for regional, to promote regional writers, promote regional literatures with the help of communication language as English or Hindi.
One of the ways of dealing with that would be to have someone who would interpret, so that someone asked a question in Konkani and there would be an interpreter there. I mean, that's a very simple way of dealing with that question. I find, because I've published 14 books in Hindi, and the Hindi atmosphere is also very different from the English literature festivals. And the Hindi festivals were not always called literature festivals. I mean, you call them by different names. I once went many years ago, 1981, to a Vishwa Hindi Sammelan in Delhi. And that was also a meeting of intellectuals, and it was writers, and it was everything. But the atmosphere there was very different from an atmosphere at Jaipur or somewhere else. And I just think that, you know, there's a development. There's this English-speaking elite, yes, sure. Someone talked about like being in a gym and you'll see all these, well, you know, six-pack abs, and those are the ones, but then you're not, and then you feel sort of out of it. But I think it's a question of claiming that space and saying that what we're doing is important and we need to claim that space.
I wanted to ask, we have just 10 minutes left, so anybody has questions for this session. Yes. Let me know if you want to direct it to a specific person.
Hi, this is Alfred, and this is more to get your opinion about a lot of people in busy schedules cannot like participate for like a 3-day session, but they definitely like to be would like to view it. So what is be your idea in terms of streaming these sessions over the internet so that you know you have
that really doesn't answer stick to your topic, but it's more of a technical issue. But you want to meaning this is something we can do, of course.
Most of the festival sessions are online. See them later, not at the same time, but later you can view them online.
Anybody else? Any questions? Yeah, Augusto.
Any other questions?
This is to do with Leonard's final question about these festivals being mainly in English. And it's a pity that, as Bai Mauzo has pointed out, that many of the regional writers don't come here because they feel left out. What could be done about this?
Yeah,
a lovely suggestion was given.
Do we need a quest? Do we need a Konkani festival? Because that will again defeat the purpose, right? Meaning,
If you have that, then you have the opposite happen.
Yeah, exactly.
People here would not go there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we annually we have Konkani, Akhil Bharatiya Konkani Sahitya Sammelan, Akhil Bharat or Akhil Goa Marathi Sahitya Sammelan. We regional language sammelans, again festivals, do happen in Goa, where those writers who write in Konkani only, they come there, or writing only in Marathi, they gather and discuss their own literature. This has a pan-India view. I think it is up to the writers. They should come here. Of course, they need some communicative skill, if not to speak, at least to listen and understand. And I think that much capability our writers have. So they should attend and learn from writers from across the country, across our borders, and writers from across India. We don't get opportunity to interact with them. Here we have. And this is precisely what I'm telling you. The intimate ambience at this festival makes every writer accessible for anybody, for reader, you can see the young GALF going on. Young minds are very much engrossed in literature. Today, my friend Pantalia is minding his stall. He brought his young son, about maybe 8 years or 10 years old. He went around, picked up 10 books, and came to his mother. And mother was also there. And she shouted at him. And then Pantalia said, no, he's a good reader. Let us buy all 10 books he selected. So this is the kind of ambience that we offer. And I think it's up to the people to take benefit of such festivals.
Bhai, I want to just suggest another thing. You writers should promote translators.
Yeah, I was about to say that. because even if we spoke about Konkani literature at Goa Arts and Literature Festival, and there is interest about Konkani literature, where does a Mitra Phukan get a book if it's not translated into English? And I think that I keep saying this to many people who ask me and who bother to listen to what I say, is that Konkani is probably the most under-translated language among Indian languages. Bai Mauzo is there, Mahabaleshwar style, very few. But carry on.
One other thing I would like to mention, literary festivals neglect certain genres, plays. At the moment, I'm currently translating Pundlik Naik's plays, and some of these mature work are brilliant. But nobody wants to touch them, neither literary festival nor publishers.
Festivals
poetry,
do not translate.
In fact, is comparatively, there's a lot of attention given to poetry. But drama, no.
Yeah.
Just count the numbers.
Augusto,
count the number of sessions.
Let me explain about this. Do you know a play is being read out at from 4 to 5? How many people were in the audience? I felt so sorry. They were so keenly attempting to reach out to the audience, but hardly about 20, 25, 30 people were sitting in the audience. Of course, people on the periphery could hear it, but that is not the way to attend to the play. I immediately expressed to my friends, I said, we should have given a slot for them, independent of other parallel sessions. Then only people would go and attend. Play is one thing that you can enjoy only when you go to see. It is not the music. Some jazz playing is different. Play is different. But I agree with you that the best way to reach out to the masses. And Kokani movement, whether theater or natak, we have reached out to the masses through this medium, through the medium of plays. And a very, very effective medium, I would say.
Yeah, I think we're run out of time. Is there a last question we can? Yes, ma'am. Just give.
I am Cora. Mitra was mentioning that you can't make writers at literary festivals, but wouldn't it be a good idea to have like a master workshop where you have, you know, sessions for young writers to kind of get together and learn a little about writing?
Yeah, actually, there have been, not just part of the literature festivals, but also kind of parallel or maybe, a little around it, yes, where younger people, I find that in literature festivals, young presence is very strong. The schools bring them in, the colleges bring them in. So how are writers made or created? That's a very difficult question. That's what I meant, that, attending the literature festival will open your eyes that, okay, there do exist people who actually write. This book, they can connect. You know, this is the book, and this is the person who wrote it, and this is the person who is now talking to me. So that way, perhaps, there's a kind of an incentive or a stimulus that if you want to create something through the word, that way it can be done. But beyond that, writers are made in so many different ways. And attending a literature festival and meeting the author and relating it to the book, hopefully buying it and getting it signed, is one of the ways.
I'll just add to it, because I agree with her that writers cannot be created simply like that. There has to be some talent. But as far as young writers are concerned, I agree with you that we have failed to tap the emerging talent to the extent. But we are attempting towards it, because we have young GALF, probably you have not seen, at the other side, there is a young group of writers who try to communicate with the other writers. Jerry Pinto was telling me this morning, he went to address them. He found it very difficult to address to them or understand them and reach out to them. It is easier to reach out to us for Jerry Pinto, but Jerry Pinto found it difficult to interact with the young minds. Sometimes the young minds are more talented than we take for granted.
But I think GALF has also done this thing of bringing around the festival, of taking authors to colleges. Around and stuff, so it's one way of making use of the people who are here, who have come to Panjim, that you can take them out and you can host people in Margao, and I mean that's one way of yeah. Increasing the interactions between people. Yeah,
but is there time for that? One more question, yeah.
Actually, I wanted to say what you said just now, that this is the only literature festival where all of us who come here had come a day before to reach out, to go for this reach out or outreach program to the schools and the colleges and universities. I don't think any other lit fest does that. I think it's a great opportunity to meet with young aspiring writers and literateurs. So I hope you continue to do that. Although the kind of questions that you're looking for don't come forward, but maybe there's a churning that's happening.
Okay.
Our students are really happy, you know, there's a lot of, as if, you know, the anticipation is there, author is coming to our college, and then, you know, throughout that discussion, so it's a very good exercise. I hope you all don't stop it.
Okay.
We strongly believe if Muhammad doesn't go to the mountain will come to Muhammad. So we try to reach out to the students. If they don't come here, we go to colleges, we go to the universities, we go out of our way to meet the young minds. And I think if not today, tomorrow we will find this attempt bearing fruits. And just last minute, an appeal to all of you, this being the probably last day and probably the last session before American Memorial Lecture. Friends, as you go back happy, but just ponder over what you have experienced here, and please write to us what you did not like, where you found lacunas, where you found we fell short, so that we will get an opportunity to improve upon our ways and upon to improve the festival quality. Thank you very much.